Hi, welcome to my vlog again. I'm Daniel, and in this vlog I'd like to talk and share with you, my viewers, about my own personal struggle with schizophrenia. Well, schizophrenia is a disorder that affects one's thinking, beliefs, emotions, and social life. For me, my schizophrenia was diagnosed in 1999 when I was in secondary 3, and I believe that it was brought about by my exam stress then. And now and then, whenever I undergo stress, my schizophrenia will have a reoccurrence again and affects me greatly. Okay, schizophrenia. How does it affect, firstly, let's say my emotions? Schizophrenia can bring about depression. For me, I still times of the day, or that was loud and thunder. Okay, times of the day. And schizophrenia can it also makes me feel like isolated from others. And this is something that I do not know how to bring across to my family. But I thank my father who understands this. He knows that I've become schizophrenic and my own personality, which is I'm an introverted person. This makes me stay more in my room, doing my own stuff, like playing games, reading my books, surfing, all this stuff. And my family sometimes, why do I not interact with them that much, why do I not talk to them or watch TV with them, the things that it's really hard for me. I really don't know. I shared with my siblings a few weeks ago on how I felt all this time. I thought that I was scared that they are not going to like me, that they didn't test me. Well, this is really about my schizophrenia. It really, this one, warped sense of perception of how others view you. And to be honest, I'm quite hesitant, scared about how others are going to view me. I'm going to share this video about my personal experience of schizophrenia. But, well, if it's going to help others, all the more I'm going to be brave and stand up to it. And I'm going to tell the other world how me as a person, how I battled this all these years. I've been fighting schizophrenia since 1999 until my army days, until my college days, and I'm currently on a 6-month MC from school because of this disorder, partly caused by stress. And one thing I feel frustrated is why people do not understand me. Some people think I talk weird, or why am I acting a certain way, or why do I have certain beliefs. It's because it's not because I'm stubborn, it's just because that for a person with schizophrenia, for me it's really a miracle I can talk about this so honestly in front of the camera. And actually, because you just keep to yourselves. Yeah, and I'm learning to open up more. I'm learning to talk to my friends on the phone. I call them every now and then to check how they're doing. Also swimming. I also go swimming twice a week. Also do regular walking exercises. And thankfully, I drop a pant size to L size now, which I always wear XL size. Well, another thing about schizophrenia is that you need your family support. You need your family and friends support. This is something I feel that I do not have enough. Sometimes my family do understand me why I do certain things, like emotional things, and things that I can't help it. It's very hard. And many times I've been misunderstood, I've been judged, I've been criticized by others very harshly. And many times I do not stand for myself, I do not tell others how I feel. And I do not tell others the torture I have to go through each day. Yeah, it's very hard, but like just now, as my psychiatrist, my dad keeps telling my psychiatrist about how I'm not doing enough, how I'm not socializing enough. Then I asked my dad, what is enough? What is his expectation of me to do enough? I've been trying my best to exercise, my best to go as much as I can, even when my friends are all occupied, so their studies and exams, they're working. And it's not that I do not have friends, I have friends, but things that I socialize with them more over the internet. Well, it's just a difference in generation. For me, my father keeps telling me I have more friends, and I've got friends more often. Things that it's not that I don't have friends, I have friends, but things that I do not want so many friends. So the point of having 101 friends will not understand you for who you are. Isn't that true? Well, I'm not saying there's nothing wrong with having a lot of friends, but your other friends are good for you. But for me, I do not have so many friends, but I still have friends. And it's very hard, especially for me, schizophrenia. I did not know how to cope with my stress. I did not know how to cope with the changes in my body brought about by this. I have muscle pains, I have contractions in my muscles, I have weakness in my legs, all this. And my father keeps saying this, what about my thinking? True, it's not about thinking, but it's because I'm schizophrenia and all these, and things that people just don't understand are me. And I feel this video is a good chance for me to be honest with everyone. And things that it hurts me very much when people say, hey, why don't you socialize more? The thing is that I try my best. I used to be scared of going out. I used to be scared of how others view me when I go out, people looking at me, all this stuff. Yes, I've been for many years, but I find at least I'm learning, I'm growing, but I'm maturing. And people may find me emotional, all this type of stuff, but it's okay. There's nothing wrong being emotional. If people do not like you and they think that you have to be mature, you have to control emotions, that's their problem. It's not your problem, trust me. You don't have to feel sorry for having schizophrenia. You don't have to feel sorry for yourself if people don't understand you. You just have to learn to accept yourself. For me, learning to accept myself is it was very hard to do. I kept myself, I closed myself in my room and I cried every day, and initially it was depression, but it brought about schizophrenia as well. So I just have to get this out. And the thing is that if you have a family member or friend who has schizophrenia, you got to be understanding, you got to be patient. It may take time, take even years, but still, be patient and have faith in them. I'm thankful that my family loves me, that my siblings, like my sister, she listens to me whenever I have any problems, and just come out. It's really very hard for a person who has schizophrenia. Your schizophrenia, there's nothing to be ashamed of. If you help from your medication, you help from your family, you help from your friends, your psychiatrist or psychologist or counselor, you can do it. You can do it. If I could do it. For me, I could only enter poly at the age of 25 years. Like, age 25, you ask me, why you want to enter poly? So at such an old age, I said, hello. It's like, hello. I didn't even choose to enter such an old age just because schizophrenia affected me. I have to repeat my O-levels 3 times. The first time I flunked because I couldn't study well. I couldn't even study at all. The second time I withdrew because of anxiety. And the third I finally passed, and it really was a miracle. And thanks to support my family and my church friends that I could enter ITE. And after ITE, I entered the Air Force. And even Air Force, I really learned a lot of molding and shaking. And my colleagues, they did not understand much about my disorder, why I was so emotional, all this. But I'm thankful for them, because they really stood by me very much. They really stood by me all this time, and I'm really very grateful to them. And I'm very sorry to them if I caused any mistakes for themselves, and if I caused any mistakes I caused. But I'm thankful that they appreciated me and stood by me, and my very good friends will appreciate to this day. Thank you very much. Schizophrenia, it really affects your perception of how others view you. It affects your emotions and thinking pattern. I'm trying to go out more often now. I'm doing proactive measures. And even though I felt that people do not see the effort putting in, I'm really trying very hard. And it's not easy. But still, I can do it. I believe that I can do it. And for you, if you're suffering from schizophrenia, you can do it. So I hope this can encourage you very much. Thank you. And if you have comments or suggestions, please leave a comment or suggestion too. And thank you very much. And goodbye.